Hey guys, Lucas Wall here. I'm back at the gym, away from the driving range. So again, today what we're going to talk about is the elements of a proper or ideal backswing. So let's go ahead and take our grip, wide stance for the driver here. I'm going to introduce about three or four elements here. The first is going to be the trigger move. So you're going to watch my right knee kick in as I start this backswing. So kick in, and then you're gonna see me move up and a little to the right. So trigger, kick in, up and to the right. So if you watch many of the legends, most of the legends throughout the history of the game, they never start from a just static, still position, robotic. No, they have some movement. So if you watch Trevino, if you watch Sneed, if you watch Ben Hogan, Mickey Wright. So when I set here, I'm gonna trigger, kick in, movement to the right, and then from there to the top, I'm gonna let this right hip fully internally rotate, and then unrestricted hip turn, high hands up to the top of the backswing. So I'm gonna do that one more time. Trigger, movement up and to the right, right hip internal rotation, look at the left knee then fold and come behind the ball, right leg extends, hands high, complete full turn. I'm gonna demonstrate it the wrong way. What I don't want people doing is going back real still, real rigid, and restricting the hips. I can only go back this far if I do that. Why not go ahead and let this happen? If we can get people to do this, practice inside, be meticulous about these movements in the gym, in front of mirrors, it will be so much quicker in their advancement to actually swinging and applying this out there on the range, on the court.